So, you have me here in Puerto Rico with all of you people. I'm never gonna be here.
With a double-bladed lightsaber for the first time in Star Wars history, and you were up against two actors, two Jedi Knights. Was it really difficult for you to be using the double-bladed lightsaber? Did you ever get frustrated against two guys, or were you just a highly trained martial artist and you never had any problems?
For me, I competed with the Great Britain in good martial arts, so he landed the part with Darth Maul. It was a dream come true, and I kept on pinching myself, couldn't believe that I was on set, and I'm in front of Ewan McGregor, Liam Neeson, standing in front of George Lucas, and I grew up with Star Wars, so of course every boy wants to be a Jedi, and in the back of my mind when I landed it, I was like, why didn't they ask to be a Jedi? But I'm very happy that I got asked to be Darth Maul, and it's a pleasure working with those actors. They really helped me bring out my character as Maul, because like I said, not only are we rehearsing the fights, we're actually we're playing the role. So it really helps. Great.
Yeah, Mr. Parker, who's your favorite character, Snake Eyes or Darth Maul?
The first toys I had as a kid were G.I. Joe's Action Man. And I wanted to be a commando in real life, and I wanted to be a ninja in real life. So now I get to pretend to be a ninja commander. But I always say to everyone, if you ever look at Snake Eyes, just remember Darth Maul is under the mask.
How long have you been in Puerto Rico? I know it's not your first time. And how have you enjoyed your time here, your short time here?
It's my second time here, and I've been here almost a week now. So we got in a little early so we could kind of see the sights, take my family out, enjoy it, and it's a great place to be back and visit. And for many years, I've been bugging my managers to get me back to Puerto Rico and do conventions.
I just got here yesterday, and it was raining. But I got up this morning, and I went to the beach, and it was beautiful. And so I plan on coming back maybe for the Jazz Festival.
Yeah, for those who don't know, they just know you from God of War, you're a Destin.
Yes, I am.
What? I know they want to hear something. And like I said, get it for Tango.
Let's go surfing on a solar tide. Let's drift through the starry night.
Darling, let's fly while the moon is high. Surf the time and
spew it high. My question is, how does it feel to voice such a powerful character like Kratos?
Well, Kratos was my alter ego for a couple of years. I got a chance to work out a lot of anger issues. It kept me from beating people up and shooting people. I could go into the studio and I could be just as angry and mean as I wanted to be. So it was really cool.
I was wondering, this question for TC, what was it like working with Dave Filoni? And another question for Park, and what was it like, what do you think of Darth Maul returning for Star Wars Rebels and in Star Wars Homeworld?
What was it like working with who?
With Dave Filoni.
Oh man, Dave is cool. Dave Filoni is really cool. I learned so much about Star Wars history working with him. And as a voice actor, you like directors that can help you immerse yourself into the world that you're playing in. And Dave Filoni was really good at that.
Thanks, Paul. I met him once at Star Wars Weekend. And really being nice. And of course, I was trying to bribe him so I could get onto Clone Wars. And I never actually thought Darth Maul would have a hint coming back.
until, well, I got jealous when Darth Maul had a brother, and then no one told me Maul was coming back in the Clone Wars, and then, and then when my son and I sat there, and my daughter, we watched all of the seasons, and I was like, okay, Darth Maul's coming back, I better start training. So I really enjoyed the Clone Wars, I really enjoyed watching it, so it's a fun show to watch.
Yeah, so my question is for both of you. I'm an aspiring filmmaker and songwriter. What advice can you give me to get into the field? Because there is not much of a field for that. I'll do anything. Okay, I'm an aspiring filmmaker and songwriter.
Okay.
What advice can you give a person? Because there is not really a field for that. What advice can you give a person to keep so I can get into that field?
You know, I personally, if you have the passion and you want to do it, you just follow your passion, which you love, and it can be good. It always says it's the journey. Enjoy the journey of doing it, and just persevere.
Where would I start that journey?
You start at home. And with the internet, there's so you can get your product out to people in a quick way. So I would say get your camera, write your script, and make your movie. Make your movie. Don't wait for somebody else to say it's okay to make your movie. Make your movie.
Thank you. What about a person that doesn't write very well?
Then hire a writer.
This question is used for Mr. Park. Since Darth Maul was a new character back in The Phantom Menace, did George do a short biography for you to make the character, or did he let you interpret the character on your own?
You know, I think Star Wars was my first acting job. I didn't go to acting school or anything like that. My first movie was Mortal Kombat Annihilation. And I knew as a kid I wanted to do action and be in front of the camera. And I saw myself working with Jackie Chan. I wanted to be like Jackie Chan. So I was trying to be all method and be, and I was asking Oscar George all these questions. And he basically said to me, he's wherever you want him to be. Wherever he comes from is up to you. And so I allowed my physical ability to bring out the character. And I thought of my goal of being the physical side first. And even when I do go to acting class and think, and I'm memorizing lines, I've got to sort of memorize my lines, action. And that's the way I express myself.
So it's for both of you. How much did you like Star Wars before you were characters in the movie and also in the games and the series?
I grew up with Star Wars. I was maybe like you, that kid trying to switch on and off the light switch with your mind. When I saw Return of the Empire Strikes Back was the first Star Wars movie I saw, and that's the reason why I got into martial arts and gymnastics, because I wanted to be a Jedi as well, as a ninja, as well as a commando.
For me, I started watching Star Wars in the beginning. I'm a little older than you, just a little bit. But it was interesting to me to see this world and not really see myself. But then they brought Lando Calrissian. And so then it made me understand that, wow, there are going to be black people in space. Oh, that's cool. That's cool. And the new one has this young brother as one of the main characters. And so that makes me feel really good that Disney is making Star Wars more multicultural.
Well, see, as you see, they've been asking me about, you've done Broadway too. Tell us a little bit about the experience. I don't know anybody who's done Broadway, so.
Well, Broad Theater is a wonderful, I love doing theater because you get a chance to do something over and over again. In film and television, you get one or two or three takes, and then they move on to the next scene. And sometimes it's not your best work, because it is not necessarily about you. It's about stunts, it's about lighting, it's about camera movement. And if all of those things work well, then your performance can be secondary. In theater, you get a chance to really explore a character. So you find new things every night when you come on stage, and you get a chance to play. And that's the thing I love about being on stage. That was what was really good about being on Broadway.
Ray, unfortunately for folks, Ray what upcoming role that we look forward to in your next movie, and TC Carson, what do you expect from the Shaman in Far Cry Prime?
The Shaman is an interesting kind of crazy character. He does, he's the keeper of the history for the tribe. But he also is very much into herbs and hallucinogenics. And so he mixes up these concoctions for the player to take, and the player goes on these journeys because of the things that the Shaman gives him. And I kind of like that part about it.
I got nothing, I'm unemployed. Hopefully G.I. Joe 3, because I'm signing up to play the third movie. But I did something recently for Mortal Kombat X. I played Aaron Black. However, I've got to let you know, I had no backstory on the character, because I was going to a new character. So I kind of done my own thing with it. So don't beat me up if you don't like it.
Okay, so we have another phone question here for the both of you. This is for TC and Ray. What's the weirdest, creepiest, and psycho-ish fan experience folks you have had? That's verbatim. That's actually how it went. Remember, we got kids on. We got kids at the event.
Okay, so... I had just moved to Los Angeles and I was doing Living Single, and some fan got my address and she was sending me things in the mail, and things would show up on my doorstep, and it was really kind of creepy because she never showed her face. She never left a picture. But there were all these little things like, I love you, I want to have your children. Really kind of weird.
You reminded me of a story. After Star Wars, we went to LA, so I was trying to get some more work. The movie had come out. So I was with my wife and my sister's there. And of course, I'm scared because LA, you hear all these stories, you watch movies, you think everyone's got guns and they're going to rob you. So we're shopping for the family, buying new sneakers, because everyone's got a list, and we're bringing back the latest sneakers from up here in the UK. And I catch these four guys following us around the mall. So I'm like, I'm not thinking they recognize me, because no one would know who I am. So yeah, so I'm thinking they're going to rob us. So I do the whole martial art thing, tell my wife and my sister, you go to the car, I'm going to wait here, I'm going to take these guys out, and I'm going to run. Because I got scared. You know, I'm really nervous. I didn't know what to do. So I hide up against the wall. They run into the car and the car park. And I can hear the footsteps going. So I sort of think I'm going to make it look like I'm running to see if they're running after me. And I hide, and they're running. And I jump out of the car. And they're like, Rain, we're big fans, And to this day, I will never forget that, and I've seen this as well. Don't come up and say hi, I'm not I. No, it's amazing after so many years you recognize just because of that fun. And it taught me a lesson. You know? It taught me a really valuable lesson.
Awesome. So I got two questions, one for each of you. First of all, TC, as a voice actor, do you find yourself acting out the role even if you're not being filmed?
Absolutely. In order to get the performance you want to have on orally, you have to be able to embody the character. And in order to do that, you have to perform. And so whether the camera's rolling or not, you're still performing.
Okay, and for Ray, it's not actually a question, it's a request. They want you to do a flip.
Have you seen how tight my jeans are? No way.
No, Lomaone. Imagínate.
I wouldn't know it was going to be.
No, not at the gym, right?
Why are you getting up?
Oh,
look.
No, I can't see my own, but I can't hear.
But hey, How about getting maybe 10 volunteers up here? One, and we'll teach them a couple.
That's somewhere. That's good.
Step back. Open your arms. One, two, three, touch.